On September 10, Apple released the iPhone 16 series, attracting much industry attention. As a flagship product, the iPhone 16 Pro Max has the best processor and screen in the entire series. Next, let's test its charging performance. It has the highest battery capacity of 4,685 mAh among the four models, and the heaviest weight of 227 grams. Besides, the size is only slightly larger than the previous generation. It is printed on the box that it supports inputs of up to 5 to 15 volts 3A. The box contains the phone, cable, and some documents. Apple A2795 Vietnam is engraved on the outside of the cable connector. The USB-C ports adopt the non-full pin design. The cable adopts a woven design to increase durability. The length of it is exactly 1 meter. ChargerLAB Power ZKM003C shows it doesn't have an eMarker chip. The one we got is a black titanium version with a smooth surface that is prone to fingerprints. The biggest difference of this generation is it adds a camera controls button which can realize various functions such as exposure, depth, zoom, cameras, styles, tone, etc. through different gestures such as tap, long press, double click, and slide. The USB-C port supports USB 3 transfer speeds of up to 10 gigabits per second and supports external displays, USB drives, portable hard drives, etc. and can read and write data and record videos to external storage. The inside of the USB-C port is laser engraved with A3297 China. Next, let's do the charging test. First of all, let me tell you the results. In terms of charging power alone, there has indeed been a significant improvement, with the highest charging power reaching 38 to 39 watts. However, this is the instantaneous power under low battery and load conditions. Compared to older models, it can get 15 volts PD fast charging first, similar to the charging strategy of the iPad. Under normal circumstances, the power change is not significant, between 28 and 29 watts. Based on this situation, we analyzed that the battery itself supports an input power of 30 watts, and the additional power is given to the PCB. This way, the battery and the PCB can support a maximum power of 15 volts 3A, which explains why. Next is the compatibility test. We use some Apple chargers and some third-party chargers to test the compatibility of it. The maximum power that the Apple chargers can charge is around 30 watts. Any third-party charger that supports PD protocol can charge it normally with a charging power of about 30 watts. The maximum power is 31 watts. There is no compatibility issue. It's worth noting that the iPhone 16 series, in addition to supporting the MagSafe, also supports the Qi2 wireless charging. The iPhone 16 series has a reverse charging function, allowing it to charge several devices. But the power is not high, only about 5 volts 1 amp. Next, we'll use the Apple 70 watt charger to fully charge the iPhone 16 Pro Max, and put them into a 25 degrees Celsius thermo tank throughout the test. The voltage is around 15 volts at first, and the charging curve can be divided into 5 parts. In the first part, the peak power stayed at 28 watts for the first 13 minutes. Then the power gradually drops to 22 watts, 15 watts, and 8 watts in turn. Meanwhile, the voltage dropped to 5 volts at 55 minutes. The final part begins at 1 hour and 9 minutes. The power slowly drops to almost zero. At about 2 hours and 7 minutes, the phone displays that the battery is fully charged, but charging is still ongoing. It takes 2 hours and 20 minutes to be fully charged. The charger can charge the iPhone 16 Pro Max to 50% in 26 minutes. And it can reach 80% in 57 minutes, 100% in 2 hours and 20 minutes. We also recorded the highest temperature on the front and back after charging for 15 minutes, 25 minutes, and 40 minutes. After 15 minutes, the maximum temperature on the front is 36.4 degrees Celsius, and the charging power is about 26 watts. The back is 37.7 degrees Celsius. After 25 minutes, the maximum temperature on the front is 35.5 degrees Celsius. And the back is 36.7 degrees Celsius. You can see that except for the upper and lower ends, the temperature of the entire back panel is uniform. After 40 minutes, the maximum temperature on the front drops to 32.5 degrees Celsius. The back is 33.3 degrees Celsius. From this bar graph, the highest temperature is about 37.7 degrees Celsius on the back at 15 minutes. At this time, the charging power is about 26 watts. Combined with the charging curve, we can see that as the power continues to decrease, the temperature also continues to decrease. You won't feel hot to touch it after 40 minutes of charging. Well, that would be all the tests for the iPhone 16 Pro Max. Although the charging power of the iPhone 16 Pro Max has been improved, it is only instantaneous power, and the power change is not significant under normal circumstances. There are no compatibility issues. The charging speed does not change much, but the last 20% takes longer. According to Apple's official statement, this is more helpful in extending battery life. But the temperature control is good, you won't feel hot to touch it after 40 minutes of charging. Additionally, it is worth mentioning that both the iPhone 15 and 16 series support custom charging limits, which can be set to charge up to 80%, as well as different battery levels such as 85%, 90%, and 95%. However, the 14 series and earlier models do not support this. Okay. That's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. See you next time. Bye.